Hey everyone, my name is Sahil and the person I am going to talk about today is Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. So it is indeed rare for the world to witness a leader that is intelligent, wise, selfless and loved by all. His full name was Dr. Abul Pakir Jainuddin Abdul Kalam. He was one such leader. Furthermore, he was a man who was a very strong appeal among the masses. Moreover, his political stature is way above the discriminatory lines of caste and religion. Talking about his early life, APJ Abdul Kalam came into this world on 15 October 1931. At a time when India was under British occupation. He was born to a Tamil Muslim family in Tamil Nadu. His father was a boat owner while his mother was a housewife. Furthermore, Kalam had five siblings and he was the youngest of the lot. In school, Kalam was an average student but was still very hardworking and bright. I think this is certainly a great opportunity for all the average students out there that being average, we must never underestimate ourselves and continue doing the hard work. In the year 1960s, Kalam's graduation took place from Madras Institute of Technology. The association of Kalam took place with the DRDS, that is Defence Research and Development Service. Furthermore, he joined as a scientist at Aeronautical Department, Aeronautical Development Establishment of the Defence Research and Development of Organization, that is DRDO. These were the beginning achievements of his prestigious career as a scientist. Big achievement for Kalam, when he came as a project director at ISRO, was the first ever satellite launch vehicle, that was SLV-3. The satellite was responsible for the deployment of Rohini satellite in the 1980. Moreover, Kalam was highly influential in the development of PSLV and SLV projects. Both projects were successful, bringing an enhancement in the reputation of Kalam. Furthermore, the development of ballistic missiles was possibly because of the efforts of this man. Most noteworthy, Kalam earned the esteemed title of the missile man. The government of India became aware about the brilliance of this man and made him the chief executive of the IGMDP, which is Integrated Guided Missiles Development Program. Furthermore, this program was responsible for the research and development of missiles. The achievements of this distinguished man didn't stop there. More success was came into the form of Agni and Prithvi missiles. Once again, Kalam was influential in the development of these missiles. It was during the tenure in IGMDP that Kalam played an instrumental role in the development of missiles like Agni and Prithvi. Most likely, Kalam was a key figure in the Pokhran 2 nuclear test. Being the President of India, he had the honor of being the 11th President of India. This marked another tremendous feat in an already memorable career. This highly acclaimed personality became President after winning the 2002 President's election by a massive margin. Saying that Indian people love APJ Abdul Kalam would be a massive understatement. The Indian people have a huge affection for this man. Consequently, he was known as the People's President. The man had to face only a few critics in his entire life. The entire nation reacted to his death with grief. Kalam was a great asset to India. His unparalleled contributions in the field of science took India to new heights. Kalam's presidency was characterized by peace and efficiency. Leaders keep on coming and going. Every once in a while, we come across someone as preeminent as Kalam. His name will certainly go down in history as one of the greatest presidents that India has ever seen. Moreover, people will also remember him as a brilliant scientist. The man was a precious gem for each and every Indian. Thank you.